Hey guys, Becky here with Design Bundles, and I'm super excited to have you join me today. We have another great sublimation tutorial. This time, we're taking letter size prints from a small format printer, combining them and making a large garden flag.
All right, guys, so here we are in Sawgrass Creative Studio, and I have what is hopefully a really neat hack for you guys. I enjoy it. I think it's pretty easy. And if you're not familiar with any other type of designing software, then this is a really good project to learn on. Now, what I'm going to do, first and foremost, let's talk about our canvas size. Now, I haven't done anything to this work area, so I'm just going to scroll down and click on Custom Canvas. I'm going to change the unit to inches. Now, I want to say that the garden flag design that we're going to use today, it actually needs to be sized to roughly, the garden flags are about 12.5 by 16.5. So we're going to do 13.5 by 17.5, okay? Now, the next thing I want to do is I'm going to go to Galleries, My Images, and Upload an Image. Now, of course, this is a design that I downloaded from Design Bundles. Let's see. All right, so then I'm going to click on our image, and that will bring our image here into our design area. Now, remember, I set this canvas size so that it will represent the size of our garden flag. And what I want to do is I'm going to uncheck the lock aspect ratio because it doesn't match exactly. And I want to make this come pretty close to the edge. It doesn't have to go all the way. Now, I'm just saying you won't always want to uncheck the lock aspect ratio. This design just happens to work with it. That way we don't cut off any part of the top and bottom. We're basically just getting a preview here of what we want it to look like. Okay, so if we scroll up, it'll tell you this is at about 2.86 inches and right at 17 inches. So I am going to make it just a little wider. I want to get that closer to the 13 inch mark. All right, so 13 and 17, we're going to lock aspect ratio. Now this size is not going to stay this size. Okay, watch what I mean. We're going to come back to custom canvas. We're going to go, but remember we're at 13 inches wide. We're going to go back to the 8.5 by 11 because that's the size that our printer has. So it does shrink our design down. See the new measurements over here? But the reason that I did that is because now I can just increase it, and I was able to get the preview so that I could see, you know, that my design was big enough and I could pick the right aspect ratio. Does that make sense? So I'm going to make this right at 13 inches, just like I had it. Okay, 13 by 17, roughly. And I'm going to put this in the top corner. And now I can go ahead and I'm going to print the first page and see how it only prints that. I promise it gets better. We're going to switch that to polyester and hit print. So our print has been queued. And now all we have to do is wait for the print manager to go ahead and pop up. Now, all of our settings should transfer over. It looks like they do. We should get a little preview over here. We're going to go ahead and click print. So then what we're going to do is take this design and move it on over here. Again, just leaving a little bit of a white border. And we're going to print again. And we're basically going to repeat this step 4 times, okay? Because we need a sheet of paper to cover each corner of our design. Okay, so now that all 4 pages are printed, we can focus on piecing these back together and go ahead and heat pressing them onto our garden flag. So let's go take care of that.
All right, guys, so let's talk about what we have here. I have some butcher paper, a pressing mat. This is my garden flag, and then these are my 4 sheets for my design. Okay, so you can see how they're going to overlap. Let's see, there we go, and there we go. All right, but overall, our design is pretty much the size that we need it, and that's what it's all about, guys. And I don't know if I reiterated this in the software part or not, but it's all about figuring out what size that you need your design, and then going ahead and sizing your canvas back down recreating that size since you already figured that part out, and then just printing it in a tiled format. Okay. Now, a lot of people will ask me if I have, you know, these overlapping sections, you know, is that going to be a concern? Well, yes and no. I do want to, you know, try to keep the overlapping to a minimum. So if you want to, you can trim some of these down. I don't have a problem using my easy press and pressing in these multiple sections. But if you notice it, then definitely try to trim down as close as you can. All right, now I have just a straight edge paper trimmer because I do at least need to trim down the white areas off the parts that are gonna overlap, okay? So I'm just going to, I don't even have to use a paper trimmer for this. I could easily use a pair of scissors, all right? The paper trimmer is just really super easy. Now, do I have a method for trimming these? Not for this project, okay? If, you know, in the past, I've done videos on, let me see, this one can stay. This one will still need to trim the bottom. You can actually trim all of these just as long as you're not trimming, you know, areas that don't need to be trimmed, like I was about to do right there. You know, because if you accidentally cut off a side or a bottom, then you're going to be really disappointed. So, you know, sometimes that'll just mean that you need to, you know, pull up the design in your software again and just really take a look at it. Okay, so more or less, that is our design. Now, how am I going to keep it together? I have just a simple roll of heat safe tape and a pair of scissors. Okay, so I know that I'm going to need several pieces, so I'm going to go ahead and take care of that right now. I just need to find where it starts. Okay, and now I don't need this long of a piece, but I'm going to go ahead and cut it and then cut it one more time. And then I'm just going to put these right here on the edge of my workstation so that they're readily available whenever I need them. I'm going to do this 3 times and I'm going to leave these out in case I need it again. So what I want to do is I want to identify my bottommost part, which is going to be this design here. Let me just make sure. We'll do this one first. So what I want to do is actually take my heat safe tape and put it along the back of my bottom piece. Okay. And what that's going to do is create a sticky surface. So I can line up my print here. And I just want to make sure that I'm covering all aspects. I need it to line up here and here, okay? And then I can press it down. And what that's going to do is go ahead and attach those two together, okay? Now, is it foolproof? No, absolutely not. But this method has definitely worked for me in the past, not just for these types of tiling projects, but just in general, when I need to attach things from the back or attach things, you know, that I don't want the tape right on the front. Also, the heat safe tape is not super, super sticky. So, you know, just handle it carefully so you don't pull it apart like I did. So now we have the tape here, so I can just line this up. And then I have one more piece that's gonna go here. So what I wanna do is take my heat safe tape here, and this might be easier. I'm gonna go ahead and attach it to the back here. Okay, let's re-adhere that. I could trim this off where I don't need it. Okay, last piece, guys. Okay, now obviously we know that this heat safe tape, you know, if we pull on this, so we can move it, but if we pull on it, it is still going to come apart. The next step in my plan, I use the Krylon Easy Tack, okay? And I'm gonna hit it pretty hard. And then I'm going to go ahead and take the front side of my garden flag and position it, okay? And this is gonna help it whenever we go to turn it over, all right? Because the garden flag is also there to help stabilize it. I'm just gonna lay this down and smooth it out. The hardest part, I have to admit, is getting this aligned straight. All right, so once this is aligned with no wrinkles, like I said, this is going to help keep it together. And flip it on over. Okay, now we can just cover it with our butcher paper. And I'm going to press each section. Now, because I'm using my easy press, you'll see me move it all the way around. But if you're using a heat press, then you'd be able to set this in your heat press and just do it one time, okay? So I am at 400 degrees for 60 seconds. All right, guys, let's see the fruits of our labor. All right, so far so good. Last piece, and there we go. So although it took a while to get our design completely centered and to piece our pieces together, this is a completed garden flag that was printed on, you know, a letter size printer. Now you can also print legal size, which, you know, would help you to do it in hopefully just two pieces, but I had letter size paper and a letter size printer. And although we had to break it down into fours, we definitely have a really awesome completed sublimation garden flag. So guys, how did you feel about combining our prints to make this really cute sublimation garden flag? Now, of course, I love it. Okay, and I love that we can still use a smaller format printer to be able to complete these larger format designs. And I know a lot of people feel very limited when they purchase something like a Sawgrass SG500 or a smaller format Epson, but this proves that you are not limited by size. You can easily combine those prints and still pull off the largest sublimation designs. So, if you have any questions or comments, definitely make sure you leave those down below. I do love to hear from you guys. And of course, make sure you subscribe to the channel and help keep our little channel growing here so that we can keep bringing you these awesome projects in the future. So I'm going to wrap it up for today, guys, but I do really appreciate you taking time out of your day to stop by, and I will see you again next time.